It's almost February, one of my absolute favorite months, not just because it happens to be my birthday month, but I feel it's a month full of goodness and full of love. And what better time than to talk about self-love and self-care? And that's exactly what we're gonna do in today's video. In this video today, we are going to talk about 10 simple ways to cultivate self-love, not just for the month of February, but all year long. What more, I've also created a 28-day self-love calendar which you can download for free on my blog. So in this calendar, you'll get 28 simple tasks to do, one for each day, and I've also included a tiny heart for each task, so once you're done with it, you can color the task. So I hope by the end of this month, your calendar is full of colorful hearts and your heart is full of love. You may ask, why self-love? I feel as mothers, we always put our children, our family, our home over and above us, and I feel that's amazing. I like it that way. But in this whole bargain, what happens is we neglect our self-care, we neglect loving ourselves, prioritizing ourselves. The result being we feeling tired, we feeling grumpy. They say you cannot pour from an empty cup. So in order to love somebody truly and deeply, we have to start loving ourselves truly and deeply. And that is the whole motto of this video. So on this positive note, let's get started. Number one, self-talk. I feel we are always so hard on ourselves. We always feed our inner self with negative things. Things like, oh God, you're so lazy. Oh God, the house is so messy. Oh God, the child is so cranky. And we kind of take the blame for everything. But we are going to change that dialogue. Starting today, we are going to feed ourselves with a lot of positive self-talk. We are going to reserve enough grace and enough love for ourselves, and we are going to talk to ourselves the way we talk to somebody whom we really love. Number two, yoga. I feel yoga is such an amazing, such a beautiful way to connect to our inner self. It's our holy time with ourselves, so let's take out at least 10 to 20 minutes a day where we can get onto our yoga mat and enjoy that calmness. I love to practice yoga early morning before everyone in the house wakes up, but you can choose a time where you feel relaxed. Consider this as a date with yourself. Number three, write a love letter to yourself. When was the last time you remember writing something sweet, something nice to yourself? I really don't remember it. So go grab that pen and paper and write yourself a love letter. Thank your body, your mind, your soul for being so amazing, so gorgeous, so out of this world. Four, embrace your flaws. And I'm not talking here about weak points like sleeping late or, you know, not prioritizing things. Obviously, those are things that we should definitely work on, definitely improve. But I'm talking about flaws that make us unique, flaws that make us different from everybody else. Part of truly loving ourselves is loving the whole of us, the goodness as well as flaws, with a lot of love and a lot of sincerity. Number five, feed yourself with wholesome food. Someone who studied nutrition, I can't stress enough on this. So nourish your body with wholesome food, increase your intake of water, do not skip meals. These are really simple things that we can do, but they can really help us to lead a better, more positive, more healthy life. As they say, our body is our sacred temple, so let's take good care of it. Number six, taking care of our outer self. And I feel this is as important as taking care of our inner self. Having done my post-graduation in cosmetology, this topic is kind of very close to my heart, and if you guys want, I can make a separate video on ways to keep your skin looking healthy. But for today, I want to talk about few really simple things. Let's not neglect self-care, guys. I feel self-care is directly proportional to our confidence level. So starting from today, let's make the small little changes and make the small little priorities. things like, you know, dressing up well, even if you're not going anywhere out, making a weekly or a monthly appointment to a salon, following a basic skincare regimen, for example, double cleansing your face and applying sunscreen every day are few things that we can do in order to feel good, in order to feel better. Number 7, pursue your passions and hobbies. Do more of what feels good, be it gardening, be it singing, be it music, be it dancing, be it public speaking, be it writing, whatever it is that really makes you feel good, do it. Start slow, one day at a time. Baby steps are amazing, but start somewhere and make sure you feed and nourish your creative juices. Number 8, get out of your home. I understand mothering can get lonely, it can get isolating, and we need somebody to talk to, even if that somebody is ourselves, okay? So take out time to go out, introspect, you know, spend time with yourself alone. Even better if you can spend time with spouse or family or close friends. And this is not about being selfish, guys. Remember, self-love is not selfish. We can truly and deeply love our children if we take good care of ourselves. Number 9, practice the art of letting go. Mothering can get stressful, and we have so much extra baggage, and we don't need that extra drama or extra noise in our lives. I would also like to mention about forgiveness. Forgive people who do not even deserve your forgiveness. Just let go of it, let go of that extra baggage, and I can't tell you how amazing you'll feel once you do that. Let go of all that extra baggage, because frankly, as mothers, we don't need it. Number 10, and we're kind of completing the circle, we are ending from where we began, and that is self-talk. So my last tip for you is self-affirmations. Write down daily self-affirmations, reiterate and practice them every single day. Begin your day with I am. So I am healthy, I am enough, I am amazing, I am the best mother to my lovely little children. I feel feeding our mind with positive thoughts is so important. So let's start doing that consciously every single day for the rest of our life. Start journaling if you haven't yet started. Make a gratitude journal. Write about things that you love, things that make you happy. Write about your goals, your dreams, and then see how you can positively start implementing them. Feed your mind with good books. Make a list of amazingly positive books that you're gonna read this year. Start reading them. Two things that I love doing every day is reading few chapters of a positive book and watching at least one positive motivating video a day. Most of the things that I've spoken in this video are things that you already know, but sometimes all we need is that gentle nudge, and that is what I have tried to sincerely do in this video. Do let me know what are your favorite ways of cultivating self-love, and don't forget to download your free self-love calendar. And it's never too late to start. It's never too late to start loving ourselves. And February is a great month if you need that gentle push. And I said to my body softly, I want to be your friend. It took a long breath and replied, I've been waiting my whole life for this. I sincerely hope that you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you did, don't forget to share it with a friend who'll find it useful too. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel if you still haven't, so that I can catch you guys in my next video. Take care, love yourself. Bye for now.